Welcome to Victoria Road Crossover Box. I'm here with our latest TBMs, Emily and Anne. Let's find out how they're built.
My name is Sebastian. I'm the TBM construction manager for the Northolt Tunnel East. And we are currently in the Victoria Road Crossover Box that provides the space for the launch of our two TBMs, Anne and Emily. Both TBMs will build the eastern part of Northolt Tunnels. That is the section here from Victoria Road side to Queen Parkway shaft in Queenport. And both TBMs will be launched soon, and their journey will take around 1 year for 5.5 kilometers or 3.4 miles. The Northolt Tunnel East trials have already started, I think September 2022. The two TBMs are making their way from West Ruislip towards Queen Parkway shaft in Queenport, and their drives should be finished by end of the year.
My name's Ken. I work as an assistant logistics manager for the project, and what I do is make sure that all of our specialist equipment arrives to our tunneling and site teams as they're required. So, as part of delivering Emily and Anne, we actually closed the major trunk road, the A40, for a stretch of about 10 kilometers. We had to do this to circumnavigate two separate sets of works, one that was happening on the M25 and one that was happening further along the A40, close to our site.
Both TBMs were manufactured by Herrenknecht, the market leader from Germany for TBM machines. Both have a weight of 1,700 tons. We used the available site in flat iron to pre-assemble the backup gantries that you can see over here. We have 8 backup gantries in total. The heaviest has a weight of 120 tons, and they carry all the equipment that is required to run the TBM. The same happened with the TBM, with the circular shield parts. They have been pre-assembled at the surface. Up to the heaviest piece was around 340 ton, and we used the same big crane to lower them then to the shaft and push them into the launch position. The TBM is like a giant Lego set. You pre-assemble the skeleton, the backup gantries, the shield parts. Then you lower them to the shaft and bring everything together. And then you, the backbone of the TBM exists. And in the second step, you then lay all the cables, all the hoses, all the pipes, in order to ensure the proper function of all the pumps, hydraulic generators, all the plant that you need to actually run this small factory. Because a TBM, you can compare the TBM to an underground factory. This is a kind of a routine, a steady operations, and the team will find their rhythm, and this is the time I enjoy in a tunneling construction.
If you like the video you've just seen, like, comment and subscribe.